Have you ever think that how the Humble Bank card changed our life? Where did the idea come from? Welcome to ES Story. In the old days, when you wanted to deposit or withdraw money from your bank account, you had to wait for the bank to open at 9 and close at 3. Previous generations who are now at least in their 60s must remember that. Then go to a physical branch and ask a teller to do whatever you wanted to do with your account. At shopping time, if you did not want to use the cash, you may have been able to write a check, but if the merchant did not take them, you were out of luck. With the first bank card, everything started to become super easier and has never been the same again. Although there is some debate over exactly how bank cards came to be, as in who invented what first, one story that in 1960, the first predecessor of the ATM machine was revealed at a New York branch of First National Citibank. It is Citibank now. The machine made it possible for customers to pay their utility bills and get a receipt when there was no teller to help them. A few years after, in 1967, Barclays, a British multinational investment bank and financial services company, debuted the very first cash dispenser at a London branch. The machine was very different from today's ATM. To use it, customers had to insert paper vouchers that they purchased from tellers during business hours. There was no bank card till 1968. Barclays Bank developed the very first plastic card that could be used to withdraw cash from a machine that was called Barclay Cash. The problem was that the pre-coded cards had to be purchased from a teller in advance, and they were designed for single use. The machine ate them once you had withdrawn all the cash. What is considered the first ATM was invented by John Shepherd Barron in the UK. In 1969, Chemical Bank debuted the very first magnet stripe. The magnetic stripe, sometimes called swipe card or mag stripe, is read by swiping past a magnetic reading head. It was a reusable bank card or a cash machine that people have carried in their pocket everywhere, created by a company called Docuil. They had an app with the slogan, "On 3rd September, 1969, our branch will open its doors at 9 a.m. and will never close again." In 1972, Lloyds Bank in the UK issued the first bank card to feature a personal identification number or PIN for security along with the information encoding magnetic strip. In 1974, after the installation of over 2,000 Docuil machines at banks around the world, the first online connected ATM debuted in New York and served as the basis for the ATM we use all over the world today. How today debit cards were created? What do you think? You will find the answer here. Stay with us. In the 1980s, credit card use was at an all-time high, and the idea of using a paper check to pay for anything was already becoming rather outdated. Not everyone had a credit card, though, or even wanted one. They were looking for more convenience from their bank, so as a response, the first debit cards were introduced. In the UK, Barclays was the first, and the rest of the country followed suit. A debit card is usually the best option, as you are spending your own money and not racking up debt. But a debit card does not build your credit rating. A credit card does. And everyone wants a better, good credit score, don't they? The first debit card may have hit the market as early as 1966, as Kansas City Federal Reserve reported. The Bank of Delaware and the U.S. piloted the card. And by the 70s, several other banks were trying out similar ideas. Robert Manning, the author of Credit Card Nation, said debit card usage picked up in the 80s and 90s as more and more ATMs started cropping up across the country. In 1990, debit cards were used in about 300 million transactions. The First National Bank of Seattle issued the debit card to business executives with large savings accounts in 1978. These cards acted like a check signature or a guarantee card, where the bank promised the funds would cover the transaction without the customer needing a check to complete the transaction. The bank only issued debit cards to those customers who had a long history with the bank and were in good standing. In 1984, Landmark implemented the first nationwide debiting system, built on the credit card infrastructure and ATM networks already in place. In North Neighborview, US, in Canada, in 1982, Credit unions in Alberta and Saskatchewan issued plastic cards to customers that would withdraw funds directly from their checking or savings accounts. CBC reporter Paul Workman said, "It looks like a credit card but acts like a check. It's the latest in the electronic banking revolution." The 1982 test in Alberta and Saskatchewan was not the first Canadian experiment with debit cards. In 1988, London of Ontario was the testing ground for the debit card in Canada. The experiment was initiated by the Royal Bank and customers could try it out at selected stores in the city. Paul Griffin, a writer on CBC Journal on October 1988, said, "When you use a debit card, the money is instantaneously electronically whisked out of your bank account into the stores. Using debit and credit cards for online and in-person purchases grows every day." In 2009, prepaid and debit cards were used in 37.6 billion transactions all around the world. Now, with a growing number of mobile payment options and other tech solutions to access and operate money, what is the future of physical cards? Will they also become digital and slowly we move to a cardless world? What do you think? Share with us.